everyone, I am Vidya Oberoi Panwar, lecturer in Electronics and Communication of SJPN Polytechnic, Nirsoshi. In this video, I am going to deal with the fourth unit of the subject Industrial Automation for the sixth semester EC branch. The fourth unit is Applications of Thyristors. This unit is for 6 hour duration and it covers 20 marks question in the main question paper. So for part A, 2 questions, means for 5 marks we will have 2 questions. In part B, 1 question, means 10 marks 1 question will be asked. So this chapter or this unit is of a less duration, but it covers very important concepts, that is the applications of thyristors. And here I am going to explain all the important questions about the applications of thyristors. So thyristors means we know that these are the 3-terminal 4-layer power semiconductor device. The best example of thyristor is SCR, then TRIAC and DIAC. So here in this chapter we are going to study maximum applications of the SCRs. So first application of thyristor is the over voltage protection. So we will get the question. The question will be asked for 5 marks as write the circuit diagram. So for 5 marks they will be asking to draw only the circuit diagram. But even if the question is for 5 marks and the question is to write the diagram, we have to write little bit explanation. So this short type of questions will be asked in the part B. In that, this question will be asked as a sub question. Circuits are simple and explanation is also very very simple. So let us go with the first question, that is explain over voltage protection of motors. So we will first go with the explanation, then I am drawing the circuit diagram. So a thyristor, so when I say thyristor, it is SCR. So a thyristor can be used for over voltage protection of any electrical device because of its fast switching action. So over voltage means if the supply voltage increases beyond the rated value, that time in order to protect the motors, SCR is used. So here in this circuit we are going to deal with the protection of DC motors. A DC motor can be protected against over voltage by connecting SCR in parallel to it. The triggering circuit for this SCR is designed in such a way that the device gets its triggering pulse only when the supply voltage exceeds the rated value. Over voltage protection means what? When the supply voltage exceeds the specified or rated value. So at that time, if the supply goes beyond the rated value, the motor will be damaged. So in order to protect the motor from damage, we are going to connect SCR parallel with the motor. So when the supply exceeds the rated value, that time the triggering pulse will be given to the SCR. SCR will go in conduction. The firing circuit of the SCR is designed in such a way that when the supply voltage exceeds the rated value, that time only the SCR is going to get fired. This point we have to keep it in mind. And we know that even if the SCR is forward biased, it will not conduct unless and until it is fired or triggered. So as soon as the SCR starts conducting, maximum current will flow through the SCR and motor is saved, because we are connecting SCR parallel to the motor. As a result, the current will be shunted and current flowing through the SCR will be more and no current will flow through the motor. As a result, motor will be protected. No current or negligible current will flow through the motor. So the connection diagram is shown in the figure. So here we can see that supply is DC because we are going to protect the DC motor. Then a parallel SCR is connected. So this is all regarding with the answer for the question, explain over voltage protection of motors. Now next application of SCR is the discuss over current protection of motors. So over current means again when the current through the load exceeds, that time we have to protect the motors, because due to more current the device will get damaged. So here again we are going to use the SCR to protect the motor. So we can see that we are using here shunt motor, supply is DC, then we can see the SCR along with the firing circuit. Here we are using the resistive firing circuit, R and D is the resistive firing circuit. So let us go with the explanation of this circuit, over current protection of motors. So when there is over current, the motor draws heavy current. So this increases current, triggers the SCR through resistor and diode. So as soon as the SCR turns on, again here we are connecting SCR in parallel with the motor. So the current will be shunted. So maximum current will flow through the SCR and current through the motor will be less. As a result, again the motor will be protected. So here once again we can go with the explanation. As soon as the SCR turns on, the complete current is taken over by the SCR because it starts conducting and no current will flow through the load and the motor. The SCR used for over current protection should have high current rating. Means if the SCR will have low current rating, it will allow only less current to flow, and if more current will flow, that time it will get damaged. So here one thing we have to keep it in mind, that the SCR which we are using for over current protection should have high rating so that heavy currents will not damage the device. And in this way the over current protection of motors can be done by using SCR. Next we will be going with the application of diac and triac. We know that diac and triac are again the types of the thyristors, and diac and triac are the devices which are used to control the AC devices. Now here first I will give the introduction about the light dimmer circuit. So light dimmer circuit is nothing but it is a circuit which is used to control the intensity of the bulbs. This diac and triac is used to control the flow of current through the AC loads. So instead of this lamps or lights, we can use some motors also, AC motors also, and by using this triggering circuit for diac and triac, we can control the speed of the motors or we can control the intensity of the light. So in this circuit we are using light. So it is one of the repeatedly asked question. This question is asked for 5 marks. That time we have to draw the circuit diagram along with some point. But if this question is asked for 10 marks and this is one very important question, repeatedly asked question. So if it is asked for 10 marks, we have to describe in a description should be more. And this is a repeated question. This same thing we have done in the lab also. So it is easy for us to write this answer. So a light dimmer control for the lamps, we are seeing, going to discuss the circuit. So at the start of positive half cycle of the supply, so here supply is AC, so we will have positive half cycle as well as we will have negative half cycle. So as soon as AC voltage causes capacitor to charge through the resistance R, variable resistor is connected to the capacitor. So as soon as we switch on the supply during the positive half cycle, the capacitor will start charging. So when the capacitor starts charging and the voltage across the capacitor reaches the triggering voltage of the diode, so as diode will be triggered when the diac voltage will reach the forward breakover voltage. Now this DIAC is uncontrolled device. It will conduct only when it goes in forward breakdown mode. So it will conduct for positive half cycle as well as to the negative half cycle. The breakover voltage for the DIAC will be nearly 30 volts. So during the positive half cycle, when the voltage across the capacitor reaches the breakover voltage of the DIAC will start conducting and the firing pulse will be applied to the gate of the TRIAC. Now when TRIAC gets the triggering pulse, that time it will start conducting. As a result, the intensity is going to change. Same thing will happen when negative half cycle comes. Again the capacitor will start charging. Again when the voltage of the DIAC reaches the breakover voltage, because we know that DIAC will conduct for positive half cycle as well as for a negative half cycle, and then again triggering pulse will be available to the gate of the TRIAC and again the TRIAC is going to conduct. In this way, the angle or the delay or the triggering of the TRIAC is controlled by the voltage across the capacitor. The charging of the capacitor depends upon the resistance R, and in this way, by changing the value of resistance, the intensity of bulbs can be changed due to the changing of the firing angle of the thyristor. A smaller portion of the AC voltage is applied to the lamps and hence the lamps glow dimmer when the resistance of the device is more. So in this way, the light dimmer circuit is working. The next very simple application of the SCR, which is asked in the exam. Circuit diagram is simple, explanation is also simple. That is about explain burglar alarm using SCR. So for protection against the theft, this circuit is used. So in this circuit, we can see that supply is DC, then alarm will be there, or instead of this alarm, a siren or one the lamp can be there. A micro switch is mounted on the door, a resistor is there, and the SCRT is present. So two conditions are there, that is the door is closed or the door is open. So we can compare this with respect to the refrigerator. So when we open the door of the fridge, that time the light will glow, and when we close the door of the fridge, that time the light will be in the off state. In the same way, the operation of the alarm circuit using SCR is operated. So here let us go with the working of this alarm circuit using SCR. So this circuit is using a micro switch installed on the door. So for the protection against the robbery, limiting resistor R and the micro switch are connected at the gate of the thyristor T. The door micro switch remains off when the door is closed. So when the door is closed, this micro switch will be in off state. It turns on automatically when the door is open. So reset switch S is normally closed push button switch, and the working we can explain in two steps. So first when the door is closed, so as already told, when the door is closed, that time the micro switch will be open. So DC supply is available to the input terminals of the alarm. The micro switch being off does not allow any signal flow to the gate of the thyristor. So thyristor will be in off state. So hence the alarm will not be energized. Next, when door is open, if somebody opens the door, that time the micro switch will be closed. As a result, the gate of the thyristor will receive the triggering pulse and the thyristor or the SCRT will go in on state, and it will start conducting. As a result, alarm will start giving the alert, and in this way the burglar alarm circuit will work using the SCR. This was all about the working of burglar alarm using SCR. Next, we will go with the very important question which is repeatedly asked, is about the advantages of using electronic control for motors. So the SCRs are the components which are used as power semiconductor devices like DIAC and TRIAC, and for controlling the speed of AC and DC motors. So we will be using this semiconductor devices for controlling the speed of different motors. We use this semiconductor or power electronic circuits to control the speed of motors because of different advantages. So generally one question is asked, which is a repeatedly asked question, that is, list the advantages of electronic control of motors. So we have to write the what are the different advantages why we use the electronic control of motor. So it is essentially to vary the speed of electronic drives in different application in process industry. One of the major achievement of thyristor technology is in the area of speed control of DC and AC motor drive. Solid state motor control schemes methods have almost replaced the conventional methods. So let us go with what are the advantages of electronic control of motors. This is a repeated question. So the first advantage is electronic control system is very compact, because we know that the size of electronic components are small. So the system which we use for controlling speed of AC or DC motor, size will be compact. It requires less power. We know that semiconductor devices operate at very less voltages. Then response is fast because the size is small. It is more accurate and efficient than the conventional systems. It controls wider range of speeds. Then reliability is more. Then it is economical because the cost will be less. Then reliability is high, as I already told. Then it is highly protective, and the device under control are much safe because the power required and the voltages used for power control circuits is very less, and more automation is also possible. So these are the different advantages of speed control of motors by using electronic methods. So we have to list it out. Depending upon the question, we have to write the answer. Next, we have to go with the very important question, that is, explain the speed control of DC motor using dual converter. For 5 marks, the sketch will be asked, and for 10 marks, this question is asked. And this is one of the repeated question, that is, explain the speed control of DC motor using the dual converter. Little bit lengthy answer, little bit difficult circuit. We feel the circuit is difficult, but if we understand the circuit, it is very, very simple. So the question will be, sketch the block diagram for speed control of DC motor using dual converter. So this question will be for 5 marks, where we are going to sketch only the circuit diagram. But if the question is asked for 10 marks, we have to write the explanation. So we have to draw the diagram, then we have to go with the explanation. So from circuit diagram, we see that here two converters are used. What do you mean by converter? We know converters are nothing but these are controlled rectifiers which converts AC signal into DC. So here we in dual converter we are going to use two converters. One is the positive converter and another is the negative converter. So if we understand the circuit, that time it will be easy for us to draw the circuit. So we have got two converters, that is P converter, four thyristor, then N converter, again four thyristors, but their connections are, one will be positive conducting, another will be negative conducting. Then LC component is used as a filter and a shunt motor is used here whose speed is to be controlled. So this is regarding the description of the circuit diagram. Now the speed control of the DC motor can be controlled by using dual converter, but when we consider the control of the speed by dual converter, we have to consider the three modes. The three modes are the reversible speed control, plugging, regenerative braking. So three modes of operation takes place in order to control the speed of DC motor using dual converter. So let us understand what are these. So first is what? Reversible speed control. So we have to keep it in mind that in case of dual converter, there are two converters, that is the positive converter and the negative converter. So positive converter, direction of current due to positive converter and due to negative converter will be different. This point we have to keep it in mind. So consider first the N converter. So to first consider that N converter is in off state and P converter is in on state. Gating means making the SCR go in on state. Switching off means we are making the SCR go in off state. So when SCRs, that is T1, T2 conducts positive half cycle, whereas T3, T4 conducts, it will conduct during the negative half cycle. So as a result, we get the output across the P converter as the positive half cycle. So the direction of flow of armature current is clockwise. The motor will be running in the, suppose, clockwise direction. Then the speed of this motor can be controlled by changing the firing of the P converter. Now here we are using controlled rectifiers because we are using the SCRs for the construction of the rectifier. So by changing the firing angle, the conduction of the SCRs is going to change. So by changing the firing angle, the current through the motor is going to change. Now to run the motor in the opposite direction, we will make this P converter go in off state and N converter to go in on state. So when N converter will go in on state, the direction of the motor is going to change. The direction of rotation of the motor is going to change because the current will flow in the reverse direction. So thus, by controlling the switching of P converter and N converter, reversible speed control is achieved. When P converter is conducting, the motor will run in one direction, and when N converter is conducting, the motor direction is going to change. The second method of control of DC motor is the plugging, when we use the dual converter. So here we have to consider, assume that the P converter is originally conducting and the motor is running in clockwise direction. If P converter is commutated and N converter is gated, I told you commutation is making the SCR go in off state and gating is making the SCR go in on state. So when the P converter is commutated and N converter is gated, the directions of armature current is reversed and the motor tries to rotate in the opposite direction. The inertia would oppose the torque developed in the anticlockwise direction. Here, try to understand one point. once the motor is running in the clockwise direction, and as soon as we stop that flow of current and we will make the flow of current in reverse direction, that time suddenly motor should go in the reverse direction. But due to the torque, first it was moving in the clockwise direction, so due to that the motor will try to remain in the clockwise direction. So when the two opposing torques becomes equal, the motor will stop, provided N convert is also commutated. So this process of making the motor stop is called as plug. Once it will be running in the clockwise direction, then it is stopped, then it is made to move in the anticlockwise direction. So when first it is moving in clockwise, then it is made to move in the anticlockwise. So when the forces balance each other, the motor is going to stop, and this process is called as plugging. The third way or the mode which is used for the speed control of DC motor using dual converter is regenerative braking. So this process we have to understand. In regenerative braking, when the motor is rotating, kinetic energy of motor is converted into electrical energy. So it is fed back to the supply. It is fed back to the supply. It is fed back to the supply from the system, thereby saving the energy. So dual converters can be used for achieving regenerative braking. So regenerative braking is nothing but regeneration action. Means what? When the force is applied from load to source, so that we call it as a regeneration action. Assume or consider that P converter is originally gated and motor is running in the clockwise direction. If P converter is commutated and N converter is gated, then the counter EMF generated in the armature will act as the DC input for the N converter, so which will work as an inverter. So thus single phase AC output of N converter may be fed back to the main supply. So the P converter can be thought as a rectifier and N converter will act as an inverter. So that mode of operation of dual converter we call it as regenerative braking. So all these three methods we feel it is same, but we have to consider it slowly. What happens during reversible speed control, what happens during plugging, and what happens during regenerative braking. So this is all regarding with the explanation for speed control of DC motor using dual converter. Now let us go with the next type of motors, that is the induction motors, which are the example of AC motors. So here we are going to use inverters. And what are inverters? Inverters are nothing but DC to AC converters. Now these induction motors are AC motors. This can be single phase or this can be three phase motors. So here we are going to study two circuits, repeatedly asked question. So 5 marks question, they will ask as a sketch or write the diagram, and the explanation is small, so we have to go with the 5 marks explanation only. So first we will go with single phase, then we will study with the three phase. So we go with speed control of a single phase induction motor. We can see that the diagram consists of single phase source supply, then this AC supply is converted to DC by using a single phase full wave rectifier, then a filter is used to remove the ripple, then we get a pure DC at the output of the filter, which is given to the inverter. Block diagram is very simple. The firing angle of single phase full wave rectifier can be controlled by using the phase control circuit. So diagram is simple. Let us go with the working or operation of the speed control of induction motor. So with the help of a inverter circuit, we can obtain fixed frequency and variable voltage AC supply which can be given to the motor for speed control. Now block diagram we have seen. So by using inverter we give variable AC supply to the motor. When the voltage changes, naturally the speed of the motor is going to change. Single phase AC is converted into DC with the help of a single phase full wave rectifier, that is the first block in the diagram. It is then filtered to minimize the ripple by using the filter. So rippled AC is converted to smooth DC. The rippled DC is converted to smooth DC by using the filter. By varying the firing angle of the single phase full wave rectifier, variable DC voltage can be developed. So depending upon the speed required, we are going to change the firing angle. As a result, conduction of the full wave rectifier is going to change. The phase control circuit is used for controlling the firing angle of the single phase rectifier bridge. Variable DC output of single phase rectifier is the input for the inverter bridge whose output is variable AC. The fixed frequency and variable voltage inverter output is given to the motor whose speed is to be controlled. So in this way, by using simple inverter circuit, we can control the speed of single phase induction motor. So let us go with the next circuit. So this is with the explanation for the speed control of single phase induction motor. Now let us go with the next circuit, how we are going to control the speed of three phase induction motor. So the question asked will be, sketch the block diagram for speed control of three phase induction motor. So same type of block diagram, instead of single phase here we are going to use the three phase. So three phase supply will be there and the motor used will be also a three phase induction motor. So block diagram, we see that three phase rectifier is there, again voltage to frequency converter is there, inverter firing circuit is there, then three phase inverter is there, and the induction motor is also of three phase. Now let us go how the circuit or the block diagram is going to work. So all the blocks we have observed and we have seen the connections also. So three phase AC is rectified using a variable control DC by using three phase rectifiers. It is then filtered to minimize the ripple because we know that the output of the rectifier will contain ripple or AC components which should be removed, so a filter circuit is used. Here the rectifier is a three phase bridge rectifier. So we get variable DC output of three phase rectifier which is converted into control pulses which is given to the inverter bridge. LC filter is used to remove the ripples or the AC components in the DC output. The inverter bridge produces variable voltage and variable frequency output to control the speed of the three phase induction motor. So by changing the firing of the three phase rectifier, we get varying DC voltage which is given to the inverter. Inverter is going to convert this DC into AC and thus the three phase induction motor is going to have the speed control. Next we are going to study about the different applications of the SCRs and which are very important. These are the sure questions, always asked questions. So the first application of the SCR is the photoelectric control of SCR. So the question will be, write the circuit diagram of photoelectric control of SCR. So we will first draw the circuit diagram. When we observe the circuit diagram, we see that supply, main supply is there and this main supply is converted into DC. SCR is connected in series with the lamps, then LDR is there, and this LDR is connected with the gate of the SCR. Let us go with the working of the circuit, that is the photoelectric control of SCR. Just now I have explained the circuit diagram. So the mains AC supply is rectified by means of full wave bridge rectifier formed with the help of the diodes. So four diodes are there, and this is a full wave bridge rectifier. We get the DC output across this bridge. A part of this rectified DC voltage is given to the gate of the thyristor T1 by means of a potential divider, which is made up of resistor R. So a potentiometer is present and a fixed resistor is there, and this will be the voltage divider circuit. During the daytime, when the LDR receives enough light, its resistance become very low. We know that LDR is nothing but it is light dependent resistor. So when the light falls on the LDR, its resistance will be very very low, and when no light falls on the LDR, it will offer maximum resistance, and that happens during the night time. So when light falls on the LDR, in this condition no signal will be available to the gate of T1, because LDR will be conducting and the SCR will be in off state. So when SCR is in off state, the bulbs or the lamps will also be in the off state and it will not go in on state. On the other hand, when during the evening or during the night, when the intensity of light falling on the LDR reduces, its resistance will increase gradually, and the total darkness in its resistance will reach the resistance reach maximum. So the LDR will offer maximum resistance. As a result, it will not allow current to flow, and as a result the gate will get current and it will go in on state, or it will trigger the SCR. So when SCR is triggered or fired, it will start conducting. As a result, the lamps which are connected in series with the SCR, they will glow. So thus, by using the SCR along with the LDR, photoelectric control can be achieved. The lamps will go in on state when there is dark, and the lamp will go in off state when there is light. So this is all regarding the circuit diagram of electronic control of SCR. Now let us go with the understanding of the two repeatedly asked question for 10-10 marks. Sure question for 10 marks. Both the block diagrams we are going to study. Now the speed control of DC motor using two methods. Both the block diagrams are nearly same, working is nearly same with little bit difference, but don't neglect this answers, because this is asked for 10 marks sure question, repeated question. So first we will study the armature voltage control method for speed control of DC motors. So one thing we have to keep it in mind, that the DC motors will run at a base speed, that is the speed when maximum armature voltage and maximum armature current is flowing through it. So there are two methods to control the speed of this DC motors, that is the armature voltage control method and field or current field control method. So in this method there are different units, that is the potentiometer, ramp unit, tacho generator, comparator, error amplifier, phase shifting circuit, then thyristor bridge. So block diagram we will see in the next slide. So this is the block diagram, and explanation I have already written or given in the previous slide. So first unit is the potentiometer. So the DC reference voltage is obtained through a potentiometer. Feedback signal is compared with the reference. The value of this output parameter is altered if the feedback voltage is different from the reference voltage. So in order to give the reference voltage, whatever reference voltage we want depending upon the speed of the motor is set by using the potentiometer. So potentiometer is nothing but it is a variable resistor. Then the next unit is the ramp unit, or ramp unit is nothing but it is used to convert. It is a integrator circuit, and what it does, it will convert the step voltage into a sawtooth waveform. So this ramp unit is used for soft start of the motors or the signal. So it is a RC integrator which gets a step input reference voltage from the potentiometer and converts it into a ramp output, which is given to the next comparator, that is where the feedback signal is compared with this reference. So for the soft start signal, this ramp generator is used. One more unit is the TACO generator. So actually TACO generator is nothing but it is a converter which will convert the speed into voltage. So after the ramp unit, there will be the comparator, and this comparator will compare the input from the ramp unit with the output of the TACO generator. Now only I told you that TACO generator is going to convert the speed of the motor into voltage. Now this comparator will compare both the voltages, and it is going to generate a error signal, and this error signal will be given to the error amplifier, and this error amplifier in turns will control the firing angle of the thyristor bridge. So this phase shifting circuit is controlled by the output voltage of the error amplifier, and thus the firing angle of the thyristor bridge is going to control. As a result, what is the use of this thyristor bridge? The thyristor bridge is going to convert the AC signal into DC, and its output voltage will be controlled by the phase shifting circuit. Now we get a voltage which is applied to the DC motor. At the output of this thyristor voltage, we get a armature voltage, a voltage which is applied to the DC motor. So depending upon this voltage, the speed of the motor is going to change. Here the armature current is maintained constant. So constant DC current is maintained in the field winding. So this method we call it as armature voltage control. Here we are going to vary the armature voltage and field current is kept constant. So by changing the phase angle is changed due to the signal from the error amplifier, and the signal to the error amplifier depends upon the reference voltage and the feedback voltage. The speed is controlled by using the armature voltage method. Next, we will go with the question, that is sketch the block diagram for armature field control method for speed control of DC shunt motor. So here the speed of the DC motor is controlled by changing the field current. The voltage will be maintained constant and current is going to change. Same blocks. So we will have the potentiometer, ramp unit, comparator, error amplifier, phase shifting circuit, thyristor bridge, then the motor, TACO generator and the feedback network. So as we know that a potentiometer has been used for the reference DC voltage to a value corresponding to the field current. Whatever speed we want, depending upon the field current is set, and depending upon that field current, The reference voltage is adjusted or obtained by selecting the particular value of the potentiometer. Feedback signal is compared against the reference. The value of the output parameter is altered if the feedback voltage is different from the reference voltage. That indicates that the speed is not according to our set value. Then the ramp unit, it is used for soft start circuit. It is an RC integrator circuit which accepts a step input reference voltage and converts it into a ramp output, thereby providing the soft start. Then the TECO generator, whose output is given as a feedback to the comparator. The speed of the motor is converted into equivalent voltage signal by means of a TECO generator mounted on the motor shaft. This feedback voltage is applied to the comparator circuit to provide an error signal. So comparator will generate an error signal which is given to the amplifier. After amplification, it is given to the phase shifting circuit. The purpose of phase shifting circuit is to change the firing angle of the thyristor bridge. This thyristor bridge will be converting the AC signal into DC. Thus, the thyristor, three-phase thyristor bridge will give the it will work as a rectifier, is used for connecting AC into variable DC output voltage. The output of this thyristor bridge is connected to the motor field winding. The thyristor bridge changes the field current IF, due to which the firing angle to control, due to which the speed of the motor is going to change. So thus, by changing the firing angle, the speed of the DC motor is changed. So this was all with respect to the armature field control method for the speed control of a DC motor. So I have done the explanation by explaining the block diagram, and these slides are helpful for you to write the explanation. So this was all with respect to the applications of thyristors in power electronics. Students, hope you understood. Thank you very much.